Good morning once again, class. Please open up to page number 62. Now let us see what happens further in the story. The toy box. Up till now we saw that the small family has shifted to a new house and they are unpacking. And Tom here, when he is in the toy room, he hears a cry, a feeble cry and a moan. And he is very scared and he runs back to his room. Now he doesn't like being in the house. Let us see what happens further in the story. "You are very quiet, Tom," said Mother. "Is something the matter?" "I don't like it here," I muttered. "Why ever not?" asked Mother, coming over to join me by the window. "It's cold and spooky," I replied, "and I don't like the noises it makes."
"Noises?"
asked Mother, astonished. Astonished? Surprised. "What noises?" "I heard some noises, moaning, coming from our toy box," I replied. "Don't be silly," said Mother. "Come, let's go down and listen." "Don't be such a scaredy cat. Matilda will come too and I'll get Dad too if you insist, if you say, or if you force me off." If we went downstairs and entered the playroom, we stood and listened. We heard nothing. "The sounds you heard must have come from outside," said Mother. "A gurgling pipe, perhaps." "No," I said with some force, as I backed out of the room. "It was a cry, a moan, I'm sure." Over the next few days, we settled in. I should say the rest of the family settled in. I was far from settled by, because he had heard that noise and he was still scared. I heard the cries whenever I went into the playroom and approached the toy box, and each time I heard the cries, I screamed. But when the others came running to listen, there were no sounds at all. So it was kind of a coincidence that whenever the boy used to be in the playroom, that time only he could hear the sounds, but the others could not. By the end of the week, everyone was most annoyed with me. Why? Because they thought he was telling a lie, and because they could hear no cries coming from anywhere in the playroom. They came running to the room whenever I screamed. My parents did not believe me and assumed I was making up the story to get their attention. Meaning to say, he was just lying as he wanted their attention, or he wanted something else from them. My sister blamed me for the moodiness of my parents. So if the parents are all the time annoyed with the boy, then the atmosphere at home is not congenial, not loving. Now, Anne said that we might lose the use of the room for our entertainment if I kept this up. So she was like, she liked going to the room, and she said if her brother will keep on screaming and feeling scared in the room, then most probably the parents will shut the room. One morning, determined not to scream, promising himself not to scream, I plucked up the courage to enter the playroom. Plucked up the courage to find strength in yourself. So it is an idiom to enter the playroom. I had avoided it for 3 days, but now my mind was made up. I would get to the bottom of the mystery and not scream. The curtains in the room were drawn. So it was dark, drawn over here, closed. So it was dark and musty in there. Again, damp. Musty, damp. As I entered the room, I felt a draught of air. Draught of air, a strong whiff of air coming from somewhere. The windows were firmly shut. So was the front door. So he began to wonder from where he was feeling the air. I drew open the curtains. Sunlight flooded into the room, but it still felt chilly, but it was still cold. The light, however, had given me some courage. I approached the toy box quietly and cautiously. As I drew near, I felt the breeze again. Again, he felt a whiff of air. And then I stopped in my tracks. A moan floated up from the box, but I held my breath and did not cry out. So this time again, there was a cry of pain coming from the box. I backed silently out of the room and once in the hall, hastened to find my mother. Now see, children, can you imagine what might be happening when the boy was screaming all the time? So wherever the cry was coming from, it used to be quiet. Now this time the boy goes away from the room quietly. I found mother and Matilda baking a cake in the kitchen. Hurry, come with me, I urged, but don't say a word or make a sound. Looking puzzled, they followed me to the playroom. With my finger over my lips, I tiptoed across the floor towards the box. Tiptoed means walked silently. They followed closely and silently. As we approached the box, there was a cry and then some mumbling. An adult voice saying something. A further cry followed by my scream. And this time the boy did scream, which I had controlled till then but now could hold back no longer. So his sister was not frightened of anything, but this boy was a little of a coward. We stood there for a moment, breathing softly, listening intently, very paying full attention, but heard nothing more. Father entered the room at a gallop. He came running. What's going on here? He asked abruptly. What has happened? So he paused in mid-flow, noticing us standing in silence, mother indicating with one finger to her lips for him to be quiet. So again, the father had been asked to come down to the playroom, so he was very angry and he wanted to know, and he had heard his son cry, so he wanted to know as to what was the son up to this time. So when he entered the room, he sees that all of them are standing there and his wife is telling him to keep quiet. We left the room and proceeded in an orderly fashion to the living room, where mother explained what had happened, proceeded, went out. In an orderly fashion, over here, not together as a group, but one after the other. Well, you wait here, said father, when he had heard the story. I'll investigate. Father marched out of the room purposefully. Why purposefully? Because he had a mission. He wanted to get to the bottom of the crying and the moaning sound that his, this time, even his wife and his daughter had heard. After a moment, we heard the box being dragged over the wooden floorboards in the playroom. Dragged means pulled or pushed. After a while, father joined us again. Come with me, he said, going towards his golf bag in the hall. I think it's high time we had a good look at the old storerooms and coal bunker at the side of the house. I found an air vent in the wall, hidden behind the toy box. We'll find out where it goes, and just in case, I'm taking a golf club. So the father has found an air vent. It's air vent is a place or a narrow opening in the walls for the air to circulate, and he thought that there might be some miscreants or there might be something dangerous, so he is taking his golf club to use as a weapon. Father selected a 3-iron and led the way, swinging it in the air. We crunched over the gravel, passed through a narrow gap in the thick hedge surrounding the side garden, and approached the part of the house adjacent to the playroom, adjacent next to or close to. There were hundreds of broken tiles, old door and window frames, a rusting bicycle and other unwanted and broken pieces of furniture piled against the wall and scattered over that part of the garden. So this place was being used as a dump yard, where old and broken things were thrown by other families who had lived there before this new family moved in. We'll have to get all this rubbish removed, said father, picking his way through the debris of all these broken things. All this must have been cleared out of the house when it was renovated. What a mess! So, we could see two windows low down on the wall and some steps leading down to what looked like a cellar door, a storeroom. The path to the door was clear, so it was obvious that someone had used the doorway quite recently. Now, in comparison to all the rubbish that was lying over there against the wall, all the broken things, this pathway to the room was clear, showing that somebody was using it. Father clambered down the few steps to the door. Climbed down quickly. Mother, Matilda and I stood at the top, wondering what he would do. Father rapped on the door, rapped, knocked on the door with his golf club and called out, "Hello, is anybody there?" There was no answer. He rattled the rusty doorknob and struck the door again with his club. Then he turned the knob and the door creaked open. So there was no sound, so the father opened the door. The light from the open door and the windows on either side of it filtered into the room. There was some movement inside and father stood back with his club raised. We could hear a tearful woman's voice. So, in the next video, in the next class, we will see who that woman is and what kind of noises were coming from this room. In the meantime, please reread the chapter once again, look up the meanings of the difficult words and learn the spellings also of difficult words. Thank you.